Good morning to one and all. First of all, I thank the organizers of Vidyavartaka College of Engineering Mysuru, especially ENC department. Myself, I am Dr. Pandranga, working as a lecturer in the department of ENC Government Polytechnic Turuvekere at Tumkuru. My topic of today's presentation is research opportunities in music signal processing. My presentation outline goes like this: signal processing, music, and how it is origin, that is history of music and music signal processing, some of the research areas of music signal processing. As the organizer said, so the participant of this FDP is almost belong to electronics and communication department and allied branches. So that I name what are the areas in signal processing: one dimensional signal processing, two dimensional either audio or video image processing, emotional signal, natural signals, and signal processing, it is specifically in mathematical way, it is just a synthesis, analyze and recognize, and based on those things, what are the application. As a researchers, we should know what are the mathematical modeling behind these research aspects. Next is music. As we know, music, it is a combination of different sound at different volumes or different intensity with different meaning at different occasions. This just like a playing with an emotions of a human, as well as trees and plants, those things, the music can yield more in the trees or plants. There are so many applications of music. So even music can be act like a medicine and supplementary medicine, we can say. And now come actual point of a music, that's what you mean by our definition of a music. Music can be defined as vocal or instrumental sound combined in such a way as to produce a beauty of forms, harmony, and expression of emotion. On the other hand, we can say music as the written or printed signs representing vocal or instrumental sounds. Now, I will go through a video. I will show you a video.
First, let's understand what's music. Music is a certain arrangement of sounds. If you arrange sounds in a certain way, it will become noise. If you arrange sounds in a different way, it will become music. There's a whole lot of noise passing as music right now, okay? If you know something about classical music, you would see classical music involves an enormous amount of mathematics behind it. This is a structure. A mathematical structure is being built.
Okay, now come back to the music. There is a meaning of arrangement of sound at different way. There will be a mathematical structure. Now, the background or an history from the mythology, we can say before the Vedic period, or we can say each god or goddess has some representation of musical instrument, like Pani or Saraswati has the Veena, and Lord Shiva has the Dhamaruga, and Lord Vishnu has the Shankha, and Lord Krishna has the flute, and Lord Narad has the Thamburi. So these are the indication of the origin of Indian musical instrument as well as the music. So there will be a combination of music and the dance will be enlightened in the period of Vedas, that too the combination of the music as well as the some features of dance is written in the Veda called as Samaveda. Samaveda is especially gives an enormous amount of enlightenment with respect to the music. Now, next thing is, if you observe any occasions or any functions, there will be a group of musicians they are going to create. It is an art of creation of a music, melodious or depending upon the requirement of the position of the function. It may be a good function or a bad function. In a marriage, there will be the background music will be like some significance at particular occasions. And if you consider during the death, there will be a tamate vadya, tamate sounds for the purpose of sadness or something like, depending upon the occasion, they will play the particular sounds. Even in the hotels, low background music. Even some institution started music which will be act like a catalyst to improve the way of learners in the schools and colleges. Now go to the next slide. Some of the instruments, maybe strings or piano and other drum set, there are saxophone like that. Now if you look at into the history, the who all done the research in the Indian music, especially Sir C.V. Raman has did his research in the field of physics of sounds, musical sounds, through the generation of a tabla or brudangam like that. So charmavadya, we can say it. In that he has been concentrated and did his research in the period of 1916 to 1921. Few more the supplementary papers has been published during the 1934 also. So he's a Nobel laureate. Already we know why the C.V. Raman has been famous, even though he is worked on the aspects of music's things. Now just look at in the point of why we need musical signal processing. Just I will show you the importance of music signal processing by playing some sounds. Just listen carefully how many musical instruments are involved in this background music. Just look at into this video how actually the variations of images, videos, how they have captured. Look at the same video with the help of the music.
Rakna chashak,
Observation of the alone audio, alone video, the combination of both audio and video, that is music and video, there is some significance. Or when we listen to the music without a video, we have interpreted so many pictures, picturization. Or when we visualize only the video without a music, we are interpreting the meaning or the story behind the that video. And when the combination of video and the music is happened, then we can correlate why those sounds and what are the emotions behind the music and the correlation between the music as well as the video. These are the intensity or the value behind the music when there is a addition or a mixing with respect to the video. Now we will just go through the next slide, the classification of the instruments. In generally, the Indian musics are classified into Tantuvadya, Sushiravadya, Charmajvadya and Ghanavadya. So it is those things on the western side, they will call it in the some other names. Now, so just I will show the some video. Just go through this.
A musical instrument can be classified into various types. But in case of Indian music, one proposed by Rishi Bharat, who mentions four categories of instruments. The first, can you identify the sound? Yes, it is the sound of a tanpura, which is the tantuvadya can be categorized in. The next type of tantuvadya, apt by the fingers, struck by the nail. This was the sound of santur. Are called aerophones. It is an Indian flute without rhyme. They emerged. The third major category of instruments is avanadvadya or charmajvadya. They are called as drums or membrophones according to Carnatic instruments like. Phones according to Western music. The body of these instruments is made of a solid material like ghatam. And kartal. If you observe, you'd notice that the melodic instruments fall in the category of either Tantuvadya or Sushirvadya, while the rhythmic instruments fall in the category of either Avanadvadya or Ghanavadya.
From this video, we come to know that there are different varieties or four types of instruments, or classification of instruments has been done into four types. Now, actually move to the the next slide, which gives why we need to do research in the area of music signal processing. What are the problems are there? First one is music recognition. Second thing is synthesis of a music, maybe in different instrument or maybe in the different ragas or combination. And if you have read, or the if the input is music, then how can you segment it? The segmentation of a music. Then music mimiction. If you listen in one instrument music, can you repeat the same raga in another instrument or another musical instrument or a vocal? If you listen to, or can you create the music without any instrument? Does it possible without any instrument, like virtual music instruments? Can these musics can do some work in the brain? Can it help to reduce the pain of a body of a human being? Or can it able to give or yield more fruit in the plants? Or animal can be more energized? Or can we play some emotion with the help of music? Yes, these are possible with the help of music. Now, next one is how we are going to recognize the music. Music, actually, we can do the research in to identify whether this music is an Indian music or a Western or a non-Indian music. There is a problem. Or whether it is a music or a noise or a combination, it is a problem. Now, music script can be recognized, like similar to the OCR, optical character recognition. So we can able to do some research work in the field of music script recognition, or also called as a optical music recognition. There are few papers are there, or research articles are there. On the other hand, for a blind persons, can we do some work with respect to the music? Can blind also do some music processing? That is Braille script recognition on music. There are few researchers are working on this area also. And another one is, if there are multiple music in a same audio file or a music file, can you able to split it with the help of some programming algorithm, with the help of recognition or some other mathematical model? Can you able to do it in the same way? Can you identify which type or a category, whether it is from the Tantu Vadyam or from the Charma Vadyam or from Ghatam or some other based on the resonance or some other instrument? Now move on to the next slide. The music script recognition, or so there are few research work already has been done. There is a scope for improvisation. So now it is here, just the printed image can be converted into editable image of a music or editable script of a music. On the another way we can say, so can I build an app which can read the music script and play the music? Does it happens? Surely. Well, and also that script, along with the script, which instrument it is or which raga it is, can we do it? There is a scope to do the research in this field with respect to the Braille script. So identify the Braille code, which music it is. There is a scope, and there are few articles already has been working in the field of Braille music script recognition. And now so music recognition, we have split into two types. One is recognizing the image form. There is a combination of image processing as well as a signal processing. Along with the recognition of a character, musical symbols, we can produce a sounds of that particular music, the tone. There is two. One is synthesis is there. Another one is the recognition on based on the image. And second type of recognition is record the music sounds, and based on the characteristics already available in a computer or a program, data, it has to recognize the audio signal, that is music signal, without help of image processing. It is, one is one-dimensional signal processing, another one is two-dimensional, that is image processing. In these two ways, we can do the recognition. So even in the recognition, we can say, if you said voice recognition, audio recognition, whether it is belongs to a person or does it necessary to convert the speech to text, one concept, and on the another way, text to speech. There is the synthesis, and speech to text is a recognition. And who is speaking? The person recognition. In the same way, the music recognition belongs to whether which raga it is, or whether which instrument it is, or whether which emotion, this music related to which emotion. In this manner, we have the research problems to do on the area of music signal processing. So in this session, I only concentrated on the fields of why research is necessary in the field of music signal processing, and just I given the introduction by showing some of the videos, the importance of music signal processing, and what is music, and the origin of music. From the mythology, you can take it out or point it out, and the documentation is there already in the Vedic period. Especially one particular Veda out of four, it is dedicatedly for the music. That too, the Samaveda, which gives more information regarding the music. There is a structurized arrangement of music has been done in the Samaveda. So, on the conclusion, we can say that in this session, I have given some of the information related to the music, or the basic idea about the music. I thank you, the organizers, and also those who are participating in this FTP. Thank you for patience listening. Thank you, one and all.